They have been three all the way to Great Britain. Florence in the bow, Winslow in the stern, and Florence just pulls with.
It was solid. You had some trouble in 10, 11, 12. Take me back to getting ready for your second run.
I think kind of the mental prep wasn't really any different than it was for the first run. It's sort of a given. The second run's going to be better as long as you don't add any mistakes. So I think, at least for me, my aim was just to have the same mental state as I did for the first run and just figure that things would be better just because we knew the course.
Did you figure, Casey, that you were qualified after that first run, or do you feel like you needed to come through with a better run to get in?
It was a little close. You know, we finished 15th after everybody had completed, but there were a few very good boats behind us that had had some big penalties, but easily fixable for them, so we knew we needed to pick it up a little bit to be really secure, and I think that's just what we went into this run with in mind, maybe. I mean, for me a little bit, and it was good. I think it added that just a little bit of extra pressure for me that I needed to kind of push it and perform the way I wanted to.
The bottom half of that second run to me looked really good. Do you think that's kind of what you expect out of your paddling, or do you think it can be even better than that?
I think that we can probably be a little bit cleaner just in the lines, a little less zigzagging where we don't need to, boat a little bit straighter in a couple places, but for the most part I was pretty happy with it. I remember after we got done with the last up left, I was thinking, okay, four more gates, don't screw it up. And there's a long sprint to think a lot between
the same
on the way to that last upright. You got, you know, 50 feet to sprint. You're just thinking, nope, we're gonna do this.
Then you nailed that last up, and then sprinted the finish, and you improved again on those last two gates. So
yes, those are the two honestly that probably make me the most nervous out there, just because it's a little bit of a difficult move if you're not on the right piece of water, and with the power levels being low at that point, it's a little nerve wracking. But I think we focused on keeping the boat in as good of a place as we could, and just once you hit that wave, it's bounce and go. So,
what do you call that move after the finish line? What was that all about?
We went for a little skateboard style grind. I mean, Casey and I are pretty punk rock, and you know, we just like to show off for the crowd. Even push down, the valve pops up,
and slam. All right, great paddling, guys. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Good luck on board.
That way up in the air. Pulls it around in and out of the line.
They'll be followed by Bimba 8 from Germany, Franz Anton, and Jan Denson. They had a really fun run on first. Get the paddlers on these two runs. It's the better of the two that will establish them in the top 20. They hope to advance into the semifinals. Jared Bazinson, right at point down this race course in the C2. Oh, yes. see looking at the blurry top, it appears the Germans already have difficulty out of gate 2 and 3.
Disappointment showing for Jan Benson and Franz Anton of Germany. And you see the queue come up by Kusela and Batten.
Oh, that is big indeed as we watch now at Anton and Benson to the finish line. Their first run score, I believe they will have to lean on that to hold on sixth position. Now, they've already qualified, but this team right now can pull that top 1-3. Well, still, they've passed me off. We'll have to see here. 117.